Right, well, it's been a really difficult 24 hours for everyone here at TVNZ. So we came off here yesterday morning and walked back into the newsroom. Our boss asked everyone to gather round and he told us that our colleague Greg Boyd had died.
To be honest, I think most of us who knew Greg are just kind of spinning at the moment, and it's hard because like in a sense, we are all performers on Breakfast, right? All of us love getting up every morning. It's a real privilege for us to get up and to have a bit of a laugh and to try and give you the energy for your day. But of course, when you lose a friend like this, it is honestly all that any of us are thinking about.
And depression is something that affects way too many people in this country. And Greg's death, it should remind us that depression, it doesn't discriminate.
Yeah. I'll tell you what though, man, for someone who obviously was really struggling and battling with his own demons, the one enduring thing that I heard so many people around TVNZ talk about yesterday was just what a kind and caring guy Greg was. So many of the younger reporters and producers as well were always saying, of any of the presenters or senior members of the TVNZ family, he was always the one that was encouraging and making sure everyone was okay and looking after people and giving them advice and giving them help. And he was just such a lovely, lovely man. And it's so sad to think that he was obviously struggling with so many things of his own but on the outside was so willing to help and offer support to everyone else.
Yeah, I think for me, I just think some of the memories I have with Greg was working as a 6 p.m. reporter and often staying behind and doing late crosses. And, you know, you get back to your hotel room and it's like midnight and you check your emails. And there was one from Greg that was always like, thanks for taking your time out. And it's those small things that you always remember, because most people don't. They just think you wake up and you go and do your job and then come back. But Greg was not just a mentor, but also had this charismatic and witty sense of humour, and also he was part of our Te Reo classes here at TVNZ. So I know many in our Te Reo class will be mourning his loss, especially Scotty and Stacey. And he would always give everything a go. I knew Scotty and him had this banter going on that we used to laugh at. But Greg was just down to earth. And these demons, you know, I think it's just a reminder to us all that to check in on everyone.
And that's one of the, if anything came out of what happened for us yesterday, one of the most lovely things was just looking around the newsroom and seeing all of the massive hugs that people were giving. And I know a lot of messages were sent back and forth yesterday between colleagues who were just checking in and saying, we love you and you know, we love working with you and spending time with you. So there was a lot of love yesterday in amongst what was a really horrific, terrible, sad day for us here.
We're going to have some numbers for who to call if you want help up on our Facebook page. But if the last day has reminded us of anything, there's simple things, right? Like, life is really fickle, so try to savour the little joys every day. Feel the wind on your face, you know, the shower water on the back of your neck. Ask for help and please tell people you love them.